Hi folks, Artist Mac here. Well, after 63 years of being tied in to the city's sewer system, I've been having a problem, about the last 3 years. Whenever there's a really hard rain, the water that goes down that drain pipe backs up into the utility room, comes up through the floor. Now, I had Roto-Rooter come out twice last year and rod the sewer line out, and as it turned out, there were a whole lot of roots down in there, both times. The plant that was causing the problem was a trumpet vine, you know, with the orange flowers. Not only did I take that out, I poured boiling water down the hole where it had been to make sure that the roots were killed. Well, if you're not in this part of the country, you don't know. We have had a very wet spring and summer. I mean, at some points there in May and June, we were having rain every day, just every single day, and not just gentle, you know, spring and summer showers, but, you know, every time I'd hear thunder, I'd be going into the utility room and I'd just watch the water rise up, you know, through the drain, and then it would come out, and then I'd have to vacuum it with one of those wet and dry shop vacs and dump it out the front door. Well, after a certain point, I called the city, and they came out, and they say that they checked out in the street, and there's nothing wrong. So, now this was before Memorial Day. They were supposed to come out and put in what they call a drain restrictor, that when it rains really hard, it holds water on the surface. I mean, they had one out here before, about 20 years ago. And it almost looks like the street is flooding, but it isn't. It's just holding the water there, and it goes down gradually instead of just going down the sewer. Well, like I say, they were supposed to come out and do it, but it has now been, let's see, just before Memorial Day, so, oh my God, 3 months, and they still haven't been out here. And they probably won't be here for a while, because in the interim, the city was having a problem with lead showing up in people's water supply when they had gotten meters put in. So anyway, I cannot have any more water coming up through the utility room anymore. I have swept and vacuumed and squeegeed more water than I really want to do. So I'm going to do what the city has been bugging people to do for the last 20 years or so. I'm just going to unhook the drain pipe from the sewer and just have it go out into the yard. So I'm going to do that now. And here's, sorry, can't see that because of my big old knobby knees. Here's where it goes down. And here, I'm not sure which end I'm going to use, it depends on which one fits, is the adapter that I'm going to use, and basically just have it come down, come out, and I don't know, maybe like that, just have it go out to the road. So anyway, I'm gonna do some measuring and get that done now. Let's see, Probably. Yeah, I don't know if you can see the line there. It's drawn with the Sharpie. So, measure twice, cut once. All right, let's see what we got. Down in there. Yeah. Originally, the drain pipe was round, and when they put this in, they shoved it in there, and you know, they basically took the. Where is it? There we go. Yeah. They took a square pipe and beat it into a round shape and put some. I'll think of the word, but you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, so now we're gonna put this new one on there. Alright, in the meantime, to get this thing to fit right, I had to cut off about an inch and a half more. I wadded up some plastic grocery bags and put them in there for now. And just for tonight, since it's supposed to rain, we'll angle it out. So now all the water that used to be going down there from all the way up there will now be going whoosh. And once I see that that works, what I'm gonna do is order some kind of buff colored extensions. There we go. About the color of that brick. And they didn't have them at either Home Depot or Lowe's, but supposedly they do have them online. So I'm gonna do that. So at least when I bring it along the side of the house to where they're is some shrubbery. It will match the bottom of the house somewhat. So, anyway, home improvement. This is Artist Mac signing off. Equity. Equity. That's what owning a home is all about. Equity. Equity. we got some good rain here. So let's see what we got. Yeah. That's it. It's kind of piling up here. But anyway, once I get the extensions, get it all along there and over to where the grass is, that'll do it. It's a couple of days later, and we've had a little more rain. And it's still working. So, anyway, what I'm gonna do now is make a disc to fit over this opening and just completely close it off. So there's two ways you can do this. Both ways involve this plastic foam core. This is all plastic. It's not paper or cardboard on either side like some of them are. It's basically, it's really not even foam core. It's corrugated. So anyway, here's what I'm gonna do. You can either measure the hole, and it looks to be about 3 3/4, 3 3/8. You always have to trim stuff like this after you cut it. Or you can take the end of the downspout. What you can do is just trace out around this with a Sharpie. It should give you about the approximate size of this hole. So, anyway, that's what I'm gonna do next. And then you can just cut it out with a mat knife or an X-Acto knife, and you're set. So we'll get going on that.